Hey friends, it's Saturday, February 24th. The time is 4:20 p.m. and the temperature is -4 degrees Celsius. I'm just here at the corner of Bloor and Spadina Road. And for this walk, I think we'll head north of Spadina Road and make our way to Castle Loma.
And then they were like, never mind, everybody goes back.
Shot of the skyline there at the beginning of the video. And as you can see, it's blue skies here in the city. Not a cloud in the sky, actually. And now would be a good time at the light to throw on my sunglasses. Because it's quite bright. There we go, that's better. So we'll just wait for the light here and make our way north up Spadina Road. The weather sort of has a mind of its own lately. It's been fluctuating between highs of +8 to lows of -4. And I think last night it went down to -13. And then I took a look at next week's forecast and it's supposed to be warm again. Definitely above zero. I think midweek it said 12 degrees, so I can't keep up. In my last couple of videos I had a spring coat on and now I'm back to my winter, as you can see, bundled. We've got a Toronto Public Library to my left here. And we are also walking through the Annex neighborhood, which is known as Toronto's oldest neighborhood. So we should see some pretty neat houses, like the ones on my right here. Pretty much all the way up Spadina Road here. Indigenous Community Center. Native Canadian Center of Toronto. It looks like we might have to cross up ahead here. The sidewalk is closed. Let's just try to navigate our way here. Oh, it doesn't look like we have to cross over to that side. These signs are telling us to go this way. Quite the reroute here. Let's see, I guess sidewalk closed. So I guess we'll make our way over to the road over here and back around to Spadina because it doesn't look like you can continue on there by the looks of things. So we'll just take a little detour. Gwendolyn McEwen Parkette in front of us here. sun is walking the church here behind the trees to my left. You can see it off in the distance there. All right, let's try to get back to Spadina Road here, shall we? I guess they just wanted to send us on a bit of a detour. Those are quite the park structures. What do we have here? Like for climbing. It's quite the park. We're slowly making our way back to Spadina Road. Some neat houses to my left here. This is Kendall Avenue that we're looking at to my left. Some more older houses down Walmer Road. And we're headed back to Spadina Road. I've taken worse detours. Sun fool you, it is quite chilly. It can be deceiving. Lots of nice houses on this stretch of Spadina, as you can see. All right, let's continue on here. Headed north up Spadina Road. And a very excited Mustang ahead of me there. He's even revving at the light as he stopped. Very eager to get where he's going. This looks to be our retirement residence, the annex, to my right. There's a 127 bus to Spadina Station. A cute little Westie in front of us. This is Spadina and Bernard Avenue. certainly a different feel throughout this part of the city. The older houses. You can really see their character. So some quick facts about Castle Loma as we're walking here. It's a Gothic Revival castle-style mansion. And it's now a historic house museum and landmark. It was constructed from 1911 to 1914. And it was a residence for Sir Henry Talbot. That's pretty cool. And Castle Loma actually has 98 rooms, if you believe it. I think that's pretty crazy. So, I can't wait to get up close and get a good look at it. Castle Loma was actually inspired by European castles. Henry Talbot employed actual stonemasons from Scotland and 400 tradesmen to build Castle Loma. It's pretty cool to see that it was inspired by European castles. This is DuPont and Spadina. Got the subway station to my right. Looks like we have a Krispy Kreme to my left there. Got a neat little mural here to my right. Was a railway bridge. I always think it's neat to go under these bridges. That bird was awfully close to that girl up ahead there. Toronto Archives to our right here. Research Hall and Exhibits. It's quite the building. I like doing these walks just as the sun is about to set. I think the lighting is really cool. Oh. Looks looks like we have a little kid have a tumble up ahead, maybe. I'm not sure what these are ahead of me here. They look like street lights. I think they are. Streetlights to my right. And we have some steps up ahead there that we will be climbing up. Although I guess we could go around. What should we do? Should we attempt the steps? This is Davenport and Spadina. You can see it's a long way up there. I think we can do it. Let's see how quick we can make it up here. The view is well worth it. All right, here we go. Out of breath by the time I reach the top. Almost there. Maybe we'll stop for a little breather and take in the view. Continue on here. In true castle fashion, rather, they make you work for it. Almost there. Of breath. You can see we're a bit higher now. We're getting there. And actually, the CN Tower through the trees there. Slightly left. Oh. All right, we can do it. All right, we did it. To my left, you can see there's Casa Loma from the side. But we want to see it from the front, don't we? That way the sun isn't blinding us too much. Sorry about my breathing. Trying to regulate it after those steps. Pretty cool side view. Aside from the tree. That's quite the building in front of us. That's Spadina Museum to my right. And this is Spadina Road and Austin Terrace. We have Casa Loma. It really really is beautiful. And you can definitely see the European inspo. We're walking towards the sun here, so I will turn up at my next left and hopefully we'll get out of being blinded here. Parking closed. Parking lot, rather. Pretty crazy. Not sure how far I'm able to walk here. You're not blinded too much by the sun. I think we'll turn around here. Let's try to go a different angle here. Don't think we can get out there. Just goes in a circle. Sorry about the sun. Alright, let's look at it where we aren't being blinded. So I hope you enjoyed this walk up Spadina Road there, all the way to Casa Loma. It certainly is spectacular. Feel free to give it a like, subscribe, and let me know your thoughts. Just doing some more exploring here before I end off the video. Welcome, children 4 to 13, $25. Youth 14 to 17, $35. Adults 18 to 64, $40. Seniors 65 plus, $35. Open daily from 9:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Cool. And you can visit casaloma.ca. Awesome. Something seems to be funny over there. I also have an Instagram account. It's Walks with T-Shots. Feel free to follow me there as well. See how far we can actually get from this side. And then we'll end off the video. Okay, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.